it's Reagan, and today I'm here with a very vacation traveling inspired recommendations video. Today I'm going to be talking through some books that I recommend would be really good vacation or especially plane reads. I'm doing quite a bit. I actually just wrapped up a trip today, but I'm doing a lot more traveling throughout the month of May, so I thought I would channel that and provide maybe some possible recommendations for you guys if you're doing any traveling in the next upcoming months, or even to myself if I want to reread any of these books. So I have grouped together a few novels to show off today. Basically, my criteria kind of center around the concept of something that is very fast-paced, either because it's a shorter novel that's really like punchy, or the narrative style is really, really draws you in and makes you flip the pages really quickly. Personally, when it comes to planes, I feel like I need to have my attention captured completely. I get really distracted very easily on airplanes. And I feel like the perfect travel book is one that basically makes you forget about all the things that could possibly be surrounding you if you're on a plane, a train, a bus, etc., and just completely get captured into the story itself. So anyway, without further ado, let's talk about the books I would recommend for a plane ride. First, I feel like is honestly the most quintessential vacation read, if there had to be one, and that is Crazy Rich Asians by Kevin Kwan. This is a contemporary novel that's full of romance, twists and turns, and just hijinks. It's so funny and completely will suck you in. I honestly just think it's a great light read that also has some dramatic elements and family and really relatable characters that will also keep you turning the pages. This follows our main character Rachel, who has been dating Nicholas Young for a few years. They're both professors at a university, and when he invites her back to his hometown in Singapore, she gladly goes along. When she arrives, however, she realizes that Nicholas is actually crazy rich, and she kind of finds herself in the center of all these family drama and like wedding drama. It's so addicting. The whole series, honestly, is so much fun. I've read the first two books. I just feel like they offer so much an entertainment value. You also just really fall in love with all of so many different characters in this series. It's multi-perspective and will just keep you absolutely sucked in the entire time. Great beach read, great plane read, a book that will definitely keep you coming back for more, to be honest. And also kind of just blows your mind because the people are so rich in this, it's even hard to just like contemplate. Another very addicting read that I would recommend is The Cruel Prince by Holly Black. Both these books in the series are absolute page turners and also not very long. Honestly, I try to read shorter books on planes too because I also feel like it's really rewarding when you're able to get through a large chunk, if not the whole book, during the flight. Personally, that definitely propels me to read more than maybe if the book was longer. This is a Faye-centered YA story that has an angsty love-hate relationship at its core. Personally, that is a recipe for I will read this in one setting. I love a dark Faye love-to-hate relationship sort of novel, and The Cruel Prince is one of the best versions of this out there. This follows our main character Jude, who is half fae, half human. She's raised in the fae world, however, and she basically is tormented by all the fae that live there, however, because her father is a powerful individual in this society. She is forced to have to kind of like exist in all of its social circles. She hates one fae most of all, however, and she has dubbed him the Cruel Prince. At the beginning of this story, she's basically presented with an opportunity to carve out some power for herself by becoming a spy. I'm not kidding. This is so dark and delicious. I personally think the fae concept as a setting is always so great to read. They're cruel, but they're tricksters, they're immortal, so just like everything about it always generates a good time. And this series by Holly Black, you will not be able to put down, I guarantee you. Great plane read. Next up is a bit of a longer one, and that is A Winter's Promise by Christelle Davos. I'm actually recommending this because of the narrative style. To me, just propels you through this so quickly. The chapters are ones that are very, very short. So I feel like due to that, you kind of get the satisfaction of like feeling like you're reading it very quickly. On top of that, it has the style where the chapters kind of end in mini cliffhangers, so it really propels you to keep reading, not put the book down. This is a very unique YA fantasy story following a young girl who grows up on this kind of like floating sky kingdom, and there she just basically wants to live her unremarkable life of being a historian and museum curator. She also has the peculiar ability of being able to touch objects and see their history, and she can also walk through mirrors. However, her family has different plans. They arranged for her to be married to a very powerful individual in a faraway kingdom. You follow her as she travels there and tries to basically survive the wild court that she's basically dropped in the middle of. This is a very unique fantasy story. It's very dark, but I love the quiet perseverance of the main character. She really personifies that just because you're not like loud and brass does not mean you can't be strong. When she has something to say, you better listen because it's important. I just love everything about this story. It kind of also has like this sort of Russian court politics vibe. Like, it's definitely pulling some inspirations from history, and I loved it a lot, and I also feel like is a really good vacation read. This video would not be accurate if I didn't have at least one thriller to recommend. So here I have Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson. I personally think this is a really, really great compulsive read. Thrillers are always really great for vacation because of the style, the whodunit element of this. This is a novel that's set in two different time periods, but mostly takes place on the same setting, and this very remote, prestigious boarding school in Vermont. This school was founded by a newspaper tycoon, but shortly after he opened it, his wife and daughter went missing and the case was never solved. Fast forward to present day, we follow our main character, Stevie, whose dream is to become an FBI agent, and she kind of tries to solve this unsolved, very famous unsolved case. However, eerily, some of the elements of the case are beginning to crop up and experience like in her own life. And when a student on campus mysteriously goes missing, all heck breaks loose. I love this thriller. It is truly a page turner. When I was near the end, I was just walking from the train station, running into strangers because I did not want to put this book down. I love the boarding school setting. It has this eerie element to it, but the main character, Stevie, is like the greatest protagonist. She's this go-hung Nancy Drew type character. She's gonna go and find out your secrets. She's not scared, and she is also very analytical, and just like watching her try to process all the information is so awesome. Again, I'm not a big thriller reader, but this is by far and away one of my favorites. I also love its addition of the earlier time period. We do have flashbacks to right after the wife and daughter were kidnapped slash right before to try to piece together what's going on as well. It's the ultimate fast read. Next, I have The Fifth Season by N.K. Jemisin. This I can truly attest to being the perfect travel book because I read the entire trilogy exclusively on the New York subway, surrounded by hundreds of people at a time, as I was just like unable to put this book down, completely absorbed, almost missed my stop a few times. Really, to me, speaks in strong testament to the quality of this narrative. But I feel like I've been talking about this book a lot on my channel. It is my newest obsession in terms of the fantasy world. This is an adult high fantasy trilogy that follows a couple different perspectives and really plays with narrative styles. So you have first, third, and second person from a POV perspective, and it's awesome. But this is set in a world where basically Mother Earth, or the Earth itself, almost acts as a character. Humanity is constantly facing catastrophe from like a geological perspective. Earthquakes, volcanoes, tsunamis, everything is constantly plaguing and threatening humanity as we know it. So much that civilization ends and has to kind of rebuild itself from scratch constantly. And the only info they can really refer back to is something called stone lore. Because of this constant catastrophe, humanity has kind of been stifled in its progress in a variety of different ways, really focusing on survival. Additionally, there are people who can harness the Earth's power, but instead of being kind of revered and utilized in society as a way to possibly prevent earthquakes, they're looked at with suspicion as and completely controlled by society at large. So we follow a few different people set in this world, but it is just a story of perseverance to the utmost. I loved this so much. I read the first one and just zoomed through 2 and 3. This is a series that if you do bring it on vacation, bring all of them. Ebook form and regular form, because you're gonna want them, because you're not gonna be able to like stop thinking about the story until you know what happens next. It has a giant mystery at its center and you're constantly just cracking away at it, just like our main character is, trying to figure out what the heck is going on. I loved it so much. One of the most unique worlds, settings I've ever read. The author also deals with some very heavy topics as well. I do want to say this again, this is definitely an adult fantasy series, but incredible, incredible. And the last book I'm gonna recommend to bring on vacation is Skyward by Brandon Sanderson. This is the ultimate fast-paced science fiction story that will be perfect to bring along in your suitcase. This is set on a new planet that humanity is basically inhabited and trying to survive when they had to flee Earth however long ago. We follow our main character, Spensa, who has one dream and one dream only, and that is to become a pilot. In Spensa society, bravery is celebrated to the point of, like, obsession. Being accused of not being brave is basically the worst thing that could possibly happen to you. Because of this, people are like ultra aggressive and constantly trying to prove themselves, and Spensa is definitely no exception to that rule. However, Spensa as a main character has been ostracized from society at large because her father, who was a famous pilot in the origin founding of this colony, has actually fallen from honor from deserting during a massive fight. Because of this, nobody wants to let Spensa pursue her dream of being a pilot, but she finds a thing in a cave that kind of changes her world forever. Basically, two words about this book series: flight school. You get to follow Spensa and a crew of other individuals as they learn to become pilots and basically constantly be in warfare against a different species trying to destroy them. This book series is wild, and the combat, the pilot combat, is so well done. I read this book in one day. I could not put it down. Brandon Sanderson also writes like space combat so well. He also has like illustrations to kind of illustrate the maneuvers and the kind of tricks that they're doing in the sky as he's writing in it. It's just so fascinating. Additionally, this book really has a mystery also at its core. It's really driving the narrative forward. You just have this overwhelming feeling that somebody is hiding something, and Spensa also feels this way and is trying to figure it out. And in true Brandon Sanderson fashion, that plot element is one that, well, you won't expect. It'll just be twisting and turning you in all sorts of ways, and you'll be like, wait a second, how did we end up here? So yes, this book is a perfect vacation read. It's so fast paced. I love all the combat element. The school setting is awesome. I have nothing but positive things to say. Alrighty guys, those are my plane reading recommendations. Let me know down below some books you think I should read on any upcoming plane rides, as I would love to know. And I'll see you guys soon with another video soon. Goodbye.